Welcome to One-on-One. I'm Steve Adubato. We are talking to a fascinating guest for the first time. She's Dr. Janice Warner, Dean of the School of Business and Digital Media, Georgian Court University. We talk to fascinating guests all the time, but you are here for the first time. Now, as someone who's fascinated by business and leadership and has taught at a few institutions of higher learning in the area of business, I'm thinking, wait a minute, isn't it just a school of business? Where's this whole social media digital thing come in? Talk about it.
Yeah, so I mean, as somebody who is pretty active in the business community, I just noticed that if you wanted to get ahead, you really had to understand about technology and social media and digital marketing. And so our students were interested in that as well. I wanted to give them more opportunity. So we started working with the graphic design department and the digital communication department, which were part of arts and sciences. I said, come on over. We can do a lot more together. We can work on getting the right technology together. We can work on programs
together.
And
they said, sure?
They did, for sure.
In higher ed, really?
Yes. Well, we have a very collaborative team down at Georgian Court. I mean, my colleagues are just terrific. So I brought it up to the provost first after talking to some of my colleagues, and then we talked to the dean, and it just made a lot of sense. And so they came on over 2 years ago. But before that, we started working on a minor in social media, and then we're working on more and more things together.
So, doctor, let's do this. Let's break down. Student comes out mm-hmm. of the program. He or she has what kind of skills going out into the marketplace?
Well, so our students do major in their specific thing that they are most interested in. So we do have, surprisingly enough, in our School of Business and Digital Media, a BFA in graphic design and multimedia.
Is that right?
Yes, we brought that over. But many of them will also minor in marketing or minor in the social media marketing. And so they have a little bit of both. They have their passion that they followed, so they're very creative. They can create really great work, but they also know the business side, and they're finding opportunities. Many also go on independently, and they're just
start
have
their own
professional practices.
Do you sense this as a trend? Because you talk to other deans in the area of business all across the country. Is this happening in other places?
It is happening in a few places. I was a little surprised because I, you know, tried to be inventive myself. But when I did look around, there's a couple of schools, mostly smaller schools. And again, schools who are looking at ways to collaborate and give their students more opportunities.
So think about this. Someone studies finance, management, you know, the traditional business school courses, if you will. But they gain this social media digital awareness.
Mm-hmm.
I'm fascinated by this because what I keep thinking is, what about if someone, because I went to the School of Media at one point where I did my doctoral work, and I think, well, why would someone in the School of Media say, now I want to be part of the business program? I mean, do you recruit people in media, digital, social media, into your school, and vice versa?
It just seems to be really attractive. People like to understand both sides. I mean, business is really important for anything you want to do. I mean, there's certain skills that will help you no matter what you want to do. So even if you can just still follow your passion but have that background, you're going to have more opportunity. And we're all about showing students that there is opportunity and that they can go out and be successful.
And talk about the recruitment of faculty there. Are they in both areas? Are they specialists in certain areas?
No, so our faculty are still specialists in their area, but they're just working very closely together. We you know, cut down those silos, and they see themselves as a team.
You know, we've talked to Joe Marbach, your president, about this subject on other Caucus Educational Corporation programs, but I'm curious about this. How much pressure do you feel as the dean of the school to help prepare the graduates of that school to, quote, get good jobs on the way out?
Well, I'm not sure I would call it pressure, but I feel it's really important. I mean, our students are really eager to see where their future will lie. So we really try to give them that confidence and show them that there are lots of opportunities out there. You just have to be open to them. And you also shouldn't just have a mindset of specifically your ideal job. You have to look at opportunities.
Why not? Someone says, that's what I want to do. That's the only thing I want to do. What's wrong with that as a strategy?
No, it's not. I mean, you should have a passion, and certainly you should go after it, and then target companies that will allow you to do that. But you want some flexibility because you never know what opportunity may actually come out as being something that you really love. Because what you're passionate about has not only to do with what you're doing, but who you're working with and what the company or the organization is about.
Doctor, there's a global piece to this equation. Tell us about that.
Yes, we were very fortunate about 4 years ago to get an anonymous donation that allowed us to really start a global program.
What does that mean?
And it has multiple dimensions. So one dimension is just staying home but interacting with students in other countries. So we started a program where students, two classes, one in another country and one here, would interact, and the students would work together on projects. So it wouldn't be that the class would be held simultaneously, but they'd be given a project, they'd be given a virtual team, and they'd have to get something done. So for example, we had a school in Bhutan. One of our faculty members is from Bhutan originally, and she set up a project where the school in Bhutan was creating business plans, and our students who were taking an e-commerce class put the e-commerce aspects around it, and they worked together that way, virtually. So it not only gave them exposure to another country and business in another country, but it also gave them practice in working on teams, in virtual teams, which is a really important skill today.
Final question, I'm curious about this. A lot of people perceive, or many people perceive, the whole idea of this whole ivory tower mentality, that somehow people in academia are not connected to the real world. And you're shaking your head as I'm saying that. Go ahead.
Yeah, no. Well, we especially are really concerned with trying to get full-time faculty that have had experience outside. So all our faculty have had careers outside.
Why is that important?
Just because you can then show students how what they're learning is important, that they're not just learning it to get a certificate or to get a degree or to pass an exam. Yeah. They're really learning skills that are going to help them in their future.
Finally, talking about being recognized, right, branding oneself. You were recognized by the folks over at NJ Biz as one of the top 50 women in business. You had to be nominated for that. People voted for you. What was that like?
Oh, it was really wonderful. First of all, it was really wonderful because it just showed me how great my colleagues are. Not that I didn't know that already. We're really collaborative down at Georgian Court.
They nominated you.
They did nominate me.
And I've been to that event at NJ Biz where they have the top 50 women in business. It's a great event.
It is a great event. And what was especially exciting, another member of my business advisory council was also nominated and received it at the same time from Hackensack Meridian. So we had a good time together.
Well, you're a team player.
Thank you.
Dr. Janice Warner is the Dean of the School of Business and Digital Media at Georgian Court University. Tell everyone Georgian Court is based.
In Lakewood, New Jersey, down in Ocean County.
Great stuff. Give our best to President Marbach.
I will. Thank you so much.
We'll be right back right after this.
One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation, celebrating over 25 years of broadcast excellence. Funding for this edition of One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been provided by ADP, Partners for Health Foundation, the Healthcare Foundation of New Jersey, New Jersey Sharing Network, Holy Name Medical Center in Teaneck, New Jersey, Kessler Foundation, and by the law firm of Gibbons, PC. Transportation provided by Airbrook Limousine, serving the metropolitan New York, New Jersey area. One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been produced in partnership with TriStar Studios.